Hello, all of my friends from Christine's class. How are you guys this week? I hope that you're doing well. On this Wednesday in the month of February, right? Alright guys, we're going to have a lot of fun like we always do, right? Some of the songs that we're going to do might seem familiar. I'm going to pick a couple that I've really enjoyed that we've been doing so far this winter. And then we have a couple new songs too. One for our presidents, right? For President's Day that just passed. So, are you ready? Okay, let's get started. Okay, so since President's Day just happened, right, on February 15th, I thought we should do a little song for the presidents. What do you think? Right? And did you know, and this will be a good little lesson for us to learn about our money, right? Did you know that there's a different president on all of our coins? So what kind of coin is this? It's a penny, right? It's a penny. And did you know that there is a president on our penny? That person is a president. Do you know which president it was? That's right, Abraham Lincoln. Abraham Lincoln was our 16th president. So a penny is worth 1 cent. Then we have this one. This is called a nickel. It's worth 5 cents. Some of you might already know this, but if not, it's worth 5 cents. Show me five. Five. So it's worth five of these. And there's a guy on the nickel too. Does anybody know who was on the nickel? His name was Thomas Jefferson, and Thomas Jefferson was our third president. So he was here a long, long time ago. Then, after the nickel, we have this little tiny one called the dime, and this one is worth 10 cents, right? And there's another president on our dime. Does anybody know who's on the dime? What his name was? It's really specific. Franklin Roosevelt, right? And he was our 32nd president. 32nd president. And then we have this nice big coin called the quarter, and that is worth 25 cents, 25 of these little pennies. And the president who was on the quarter was our very first president of the United States. And he's also on our $1 bill. Does anybody know his name? George Washington. That's right, you guys are so smart. So let's sing a little song for our presidents in honor of President's Day. And it's always good to kind of go over who's on each coin because sometimes I forget, right? Maybe you know, but here we go. Do you know the president? The president, the president. Do you know the president? His face is on the penny. So which one's the penny? It's this one. Do you remember who's on the penny? All right, here we go. Let's find out. Maybe you remember. Yes, we know the president, the president, the president. Yes, we know the president. His name is Abraham Lincoln, right? And he was our 16th president. All right, let's see. So the next one we are going to do is about the nickel. Do you remember who's on the nickel? Let's sing it. Let's find out. Do you know the president? The president, the president. Do you know the president? His name is on the nickel, right? Let's see. Yes, we know the president, the president, the president. Yes, we know the president. What was his name? His name is Thomas Jefferson, right? Thomas Jefferson, who was our third president. He is on the nickel. Next we have the dime. Does anybody remember that president's name? Let's see if you remember. Do you know the president, the president, the president? Do you know the president? His face is on the dime. Do you remember? Yes, we know the president, the president, the president. Yes, we know the president. What was his name? His name is Franklin Roosevelt. All right, and we have one more to sing about. This is probably the one everybody knows, our very first president of the United States. What was his name? I think you know. Do you know the president, the president, the president? Do you know the president whose face is on the corner? Do you know? Yes, we know the president, the president, the president. Yes, we know the president. His name was George Washington, right? He was our very first president. Sang about the presidents, the presidents. We sang about the presidents who are on our coins, right? That was fun, right? So we learned about all these. Did some of you know this already? Great. Well, if not, we got to learn it today, right? So we have Abraham Lincoln on our penny. Next, we have Thomas Jefferson on our nickel and Franklin Roosevelt, who was our 32nd president, who was the most recent out of all these guys. And then we have George Washington, our very first president. Awesome. I thought it was a good idea for us to honor President's Day. And now we have a new president. Does anybody know the name of our new president? Joe Biden, right? And yeah, he was just elected a couple weeks ago. So it's exciting. So let's see what's next. Are you ready? Okay, come on. Okay, everybody. So this song we did once before, but it's a new song for me this year. So I thought it would be a good song for us to do again, because really we only have a few more weeks to do it. It's called It's Winter, right? Because we are in the season of winter, and before you know it, it will be spring, right? Just a month away, it starts to be spring. I can't believe it. So for this song, if you could, if you have it, if you don't have it, no big deal, you can do it without it. But if you have some sort of scarf that you can get for this song, it's just fun to kind of, you know, make it go all around to kind of represent the wind and the snow for winter. And then when we sing, maybe you remember this on La, you can throw it up in the air. La, 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 la. And remember, if you don't have a scarf, that's okay. You could use a scarf that you wore to school if you have a scarf. If you're home, you could use a dish towel or a small blanket. Whatever you have. If not, you have your hands and you can move them in the air. All right? All right, let's have some fun singing this song about winter. I really like this song and I hope that you enjoy it too. Here we go. Get a little louder and sing mezzo forte. When I feel the cold in the air, when I see the wind whipping through, when I see the snow on the ground, then I know it's winter. All right, now we're going to use our fortissimo voices and sing on la. Cold in the air, when I hear the wind whipping through, when I see the snow on the ground, then I know it's winter, then I know it's winter. Say that with me, ready? Then I know it's winter. Right? Is it summer? No. Is it spring? No. Is it autumn? No, it's winter. Awesome job, everybody. All right, great. Let's see what's next. Okay, everybody. So get those instruments out. We're going to play a song together today. And you might remember it. We've done it once or twice, but I really enjoy it. It's one of my favorite songs to play instruments to right now. It's called Play What You Want to Play. Right? Do you remember this one? So you can play however you're feeling. Like if you're feeling happy and you want to play fast. If you're feeling tired and you just kind of want to play slow, that's okay. If you're feeling funky and you want to play a little weird, like play it on your head or on your foot, that's okay. Come and play. We're all going to play together. We're going to have fun. And then parts of the song, we're gonna stop and we're gonna listen and we're gonna follow directions. So if I say play fast, how are you gonna play? Fast, right? And then you're gonna stop. If I say play slow, how are you gonna play? Slow, right? But for now, you play how you want to play. That's what the song's called. Are you ready? All right, get your instruments. Let's get started. If you're feeling happy and you want to play fast, if you're feeling tired and you want to play slow, if you're feeling funky and you want to play a little weird, that's okay. Come and play. Play what you want to play and let the sound ring out. Play what you want to play. Ready? So first we're gonna play fast. Ready, set, go! Play fast, play fast, play fast, and stop. Good job. What's the opposite of fast? You guys know. I know you do. Ready? Play slow, play slow, play slow, and stop. Ready? awesome job. Do you like that song? I like that song. I think it's fun. So I hope that you enjoyed it. What instrument did you play? And how are you feeling today? How did you want to play today? Cool. All right, let's do another song. Come on. Okay, so this is a song that it's just been in my head lately. I just really love this song. We might have done it before back in the day, maybe like a year ago, or you might know the song. It's a pretty famous song. It's called Stand By Me. Do you know that song? Awesome. So if you still have your instruments out from the last song, you can get them back out and play along with me. There's also a little sign language we can do for the chorus. And there's a bunch of different ways you can sign it. I was looking, so if you know a better way, go ahead and do it. But for stand, this is the sign I found for stand. So stand by me. Would you like to try that with me? Stand by me. And I think that's such a great saying, stand by me. Do you know what that means? Do you think it means stand by me? It could, but I think it also means that no matter what you're going through, you always have somebody in your life, like your mom or your dad or a family member or a good friend or a teacher who's gonna stand by you. Stand by me. And I just really like this song, and it's got a great drumming section to it. So if you have a drum and you wanna play a drum to it, you can shake, you can sing. I just think this is a great message in music that we can sing together. So let's try it. Are you ready? Try that. Stand by me. One more time. Stand by me. Awesome. You got it? All right, let's do the second verse. Won't you stand by me? Oh, stand by me. Oh, by me, stand by me. Right? Stand by me. Did you like that song? What did you decide to do for it? Did you do the sign language? Did you sing? Did you play a drum? Did you play a shaker? What did you play? What did you do? Did you think about somebody in your life who stands by you no matter what? All right, awesome job, guys. Okay, everybody from Christina's class. I hope that you had fun with me today. Will you help me to sing goodbye? Everybody, have a wonderful week. Bye-bye.